Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Feinstein's 54 Below at Home. At this time, we'd like to remind you to please turn off all cell phones and that the taking of photographs or use of any recording device is strictly prohibited. Thank you. Now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome author and actress Alexandra Silber.
Once upon a time.
I wish
in the far-off kingdom
more than Hannigan, more than the life
of Metro Detroit,
more than Tupton
lived a young maiden,
more than the life
with totally delusional casting dreams,
more than Ebony, more than T-Moon. I wish to play Mama Rosenscar.
More than the life.
I wish to play Mama Rosenscar. George Seurat. You wish to play Mama Rose and Scar?
The poor girl's dreams have all died.
Look at your face, look at your voice. People will laugh at you, that is a choice. You still wish to play Mama Rose and Scar and mortify Halperins! Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to 54 Below at Home! Tonight's show is a celebration of roles that have passed us by or shall never come to be for any old reason, from legitimate casting brackets to absolute delusion about our capacity to pull something off anywhere than other than in our shower. In fact, some of us might be in our shower if my legs were longer. If I just was smaller, if I'd gone to you, Mish, if I'd won that Grammy, if I'd taken Xanax, if I hadn't been competing against Susan, who was blonde and perfect and not only had a lovely soprano, but was also in Mathletes and dating the son of the drama teacher, so she got all the leads in the spring musical. If I could bow to Jay! Why do we do this? What does it get us? Scrapbooks full of us and the chorus, 16 bars, and they just say thank you. But never fear, dearest audience, this is not a pity party. This is a celebration, because the roles that could have been will come to be live in your homes and on your screens. Not only distant casting hopes, but socially distant casting hopes. Tonight! Tonight, we've gathered here tonight. Tonight will be our personal star. Welcome to I Wish, the roles that could have been. T-Moon, glow bright, our casting dreams will all come to be. Hello, everyone, and welcome to I Wish, the roles that could have been. Thank you all so much for joining us tonight, safely at home from the safety of your shelter in place. So we want you to know that tonight we've all gathered here for a noble cause, to assemble in the virtual way that we can right now to celebrate the wonderful thing that is the theater. So tonight I have put on too much makeup and pants and invited my Broadway pals to live out their dreams live for all of you, but also for them. It's interesting because the incentive to create I Wish came from, if you can believe it, a tweet. Recognizing that I would never in my lifetime play Little Red Riding Hood, I composed a sad little tweet in which I bemoaned the lost opportunities, the missed connections, and the total delusions of actors with big dreams and no stages to live them out on. I think I said something like, I wish there were a show where actors could play all the roles that have passed them by, basically to give me a place to sing Little Red Riding Hood. And 54 Below responded to that very tweet, and they made it happen. And three live shows, three in the pipeline, and of course, this very virtual gathering tonight, here we are. Even Broadway's brightest stars have wishes that haven't yet manifested. Let's make some of those wishes come true. So, our next guests are two of my faves. I've only had the pleasure of working on stage with one of them, but they are one of Broadway's hottest power couples, Kirsten and Matthew Scott. Please welcome them. Hi, you guys.
Hi.
I love this. This is cocktail hour.
Oh, yeah.
Of course.
And we're literally sitting in a bathtub.
You are, really? I said some of these dreams are only dreams that any of, I love it, are dreams that have only ever come true in the shower, and you guys clearly are in the shower.
Well, yeah. We just obviously discovered that from Laura Benanti that you sound best when you sing in your shower.
Everyone sounds best in the shower. I've learned that my neighbor calls the police if I sing in the shower, so I declined to do that.
We're in the mountains of Pennsylvania, so...
Great. So you've declined to participate in building living for the moment, anyway.
Yeah.
My guys, what is the song that you have chosen to manifest your wishes coming true for us tonight?
We're instantly breaking your rule.
No, fine. There's no rules.
Instantly.
So we escaped the city on March 13th. We
Smart.
Came to the mountains. Kirsten is starring in Rock of Ages, and her show got, like everything else, got put on hold.
Indeed.
So we left the city, and we thought we were leaving for a week or two.
Didn't we all?
I forgot to pack pants. And,
yeah, but you haven't put them on yet. You haven't had to put them on
today.
I purchased on Amazon.
Matthew, thank you for wearing pants for us. This is such an honor.
I put on a bra. Like
it's a
big night out for us. I put on a lip. You know.
So did I. I actually kind of forgot. I don't know about you. I kind of forgot how.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Where I was like, what's happening?
You look over here.
Yeah.
And I do feel like some people are going to be like, Al, you need to cool it. And I'm just going to be like, let me live.
No,
let me live.
It looks good. Do you remember going out? Like, there's things that we're just like, you know, we need to reminisce about. Like, a full beat.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Because we thought we'd be here for like a month, 2 weeks. So, This is all natural here, but
right. Day 68, here we are. And like you said, so you're instantly breaking the rule.
Yeah, we're drinking Manhattans, not just because 54 Below has a 2-drink minimum.
Love that so hard.
But also because we're going to sing Manhattan by Rodgers and Hart.
Rodgers.
1936, Garrick Gaetti's. And, you know, like we miss home. We miss being home. This is the time of year when you get to do all the free, cool stuff in New York City because the weather's finally turned nice.
And the city, like, you realize how many people live in that city because you go to Central Park that first day of spring and you're like, oh my gosh, there's so many people.
I guess we could figure that out now because that seems to be just some of the people in Central Park.
So this is kind of our, I wish we could go back to.
Love it. Mm-hmm. All wishes are welcome here, you guys. There's no rules.
This is our wish, because we have many rules, but this is our wish right now in the current situation.
All the free things that you get to do in New York.
I love it. So I just want to say, Kirsten Scott, Matthew Scott, some of my most favorite voices, both singing voices and voices of the theater. Take it away tonight.
All right.
By Rodgers and Hart. I'm so glad you're here.
We're going to disable the audio.
Oh, yes. Let me, hold, please. Technical.
We're learning all the tricks.
We're learning all the tricks.
Right.
Okay. Wait, I have to do, give me, I'm, yes, struggling. Okay. We did it. Remember traffic?
Summer journeys to Niagara and to other places aggravate all our cares. We'll save our fares. I've a cozy little flat in what is known as Old Manhattan. We'll settle down right here in town. We'll have Manhattan, the Bronx, and Staten Island too. It's lovely going through the zoo. It's very fancy on old Delancey Street, you know. The subway charms us all when balmy breezes blow to and fro. And tell me what street compares with Mott Street in July. sweet push carts gently gliding by. The great big city's a wondrous toy, just made for a girl and boy. We'll turn Manhattan into an Isle of Joy.
We'll go to Yonkers, where true love conquers in the wilds, and starve together, dear, in the Childs. We'll go to Coney and eat bologna on a roll. In Central Park we'll stroll, where our first kiss we stole, soul to soul. Our future babies will take to AB's Irish Rose. I hope they'll live to see it close. The city's bustle cannot destroy the dreams of a girl and boy. We'll turn Manhattan into an Isle of Joy.
We'll go to Greenwich, where modern men itch to be free. And Bowling Green you'll see with me. We'll bathe at Brighton, the fish you'll frighten when you're in your bathing suit so thin. We'll make the shellfish grin, fin to fin.
I'd like to take a sail on Jamaica Bay with you and fair Canarsie's lake will live you.
The city's clamor can never spoil the dreams of a boy and girl.
We'll turn Manhattan
into an Isle of Joy.
Yeah, you guys, thank you so much for joining us. The incredible Kirsten and Matthew Scott. Kirsten Scott of Rock of Ages, Jersey Boys, American in Paris on tour, and Matthew Scott Sondheim and Sondheim American Paris and American Paris on tour, and my Freddie Einsford Hill at the Muni.
Yes!
One of my favorite theatrical memories ever. I love you guys.
We love you.
Thank you so much for sharing your gorgeous like butter gift voices with us. And I miss you, and I'll see you when you're back in Manhattan.
Yes.
Cheers. Love you guys.
Cheers. Okay. So moving swiftly along, tonight would not be complete without including one of my favorite performers in the world, not to mention kind of sort of my Broadway girlfriend. Everybody knows we're together. Sorry, Alex Silver, my actual boyfriend. You may know her from Chitty Chitty Bang Bang, Chicago, my scene partner in Broadway Backwards last year, and of course, most recently as Mimi in the hit Moulin Rouge. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the incomparable Robin Herder. Robin, are you there? Hey, girlfriend.
I'm okay. How are you?
We have the same makeup on.
No, I don't have a lot of makeup because I had this whole thing planned, and I don't know.
Is everything all right?
Yeah. I mean, no. I had something planned, and it was supposed to be for two people. And the craziest thing just happened to my sister. And I don't know how to say this. I don't have anything planned.
You don't have anything planned. You can just like do a number by yourself?
I mean, I really can't do this alone.
Ladies and gentlemen, Robin Herder in an act of desperation.
My sister and I had an act that couldn't flop. same size as my sister. Oh, you would fit into her wardrobe perfectly. I mean, why don't I just show you some of the act, huh? Watch this, okay? Now, you gotta imagine this with two people, okay? It's swell with two people. First I... drums. Then she... wah-wah-wah-wah-wah-wah-wah, saxophone. Then we... wah-wah-wah-wah-wah, together. But I can't do it alone. Then she...
Ladies and gentlemen, Robin, I really hope that you can impress your son later this evening.
Take a bow, boo.
If that's
actually a prom at the end too.
Very good, guys.
His first public performance.
Ah, there we go. Something we've not done yet. Would have been in bed.
You are an absolute star. Glass of wine. Hudson deserves a big bowl of ice cream. And we deserve you as Velma Kelly, if I do say so myself.
I have years to go.
You have years to go. And I can't wait to have you back on stage and have us back on stage together because I love you as a scene partner and I miss you so much.
I'm not muted. I love you.
I love you.
Bye. Bye. You too.
Mom, I love you. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Robin Herder, the true triple threat, even in quarantine. We laughed so hard when we thought, okay, I have to do something completely by myself. And I was like, what about I can't do it alone? And then of course we had to include Hudson because the guy is tomorrow Broadway star. And speaking of a recent Broadway debutante, our next guest is, right now I'm going to welcome our musical director. I want to welcome our musical director, the absolute light of my life, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Ben Kaplan. Come to me. My love! Cheers. Ben Kaplan, wait, you're muted. Unmute yourself, baby.
And I had a whole line and everything.
Let's do it again. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Ben Kaplan.
Al Silver, you old so-and-so.
I was actually watching Golden Girls is like my quarantine choice. And I watched the episode where Blanche gives all of the girls terrible advice. And she says to Rose, whenever a man gets jealous, just take his nose and shake it and go, why, I do declare you're jealous. And this is kind of the same thing.
It's basically the same thing. I've always considered myself a golden girl.
Indeed. Which one are you?
Oh, I feel in my heart that I am Rose.
I'm a strong Dorothy with a Sophia rising, I think.
Good choice.
Sun Dorothy. Yeah, exactly. And but you know, with the spirit, maybe a moon rose. Who knows? This is for actual drinks. Ben, where are you sheltering in place?
I am here in beautiful Towson, Maryland.
It looks beautiful.
If you don't know Towson, Maryland, it is the home of Towson University.
Great.
A wonderful theater program. If you're a young high school performer who's looking for a great acting program.
Yes, dare we say it, wishes.
Wishes indeed.
Now, I have a question. How does one musically direct a show that normally you would be sitting at the keys at 54 Below accompanying us live, having that wonderful collaborative piano experience with their performer. But how have you musical directed tonight's virtual performance?
Well, they wouldn't let me take the piano from 54 Below.
Jerks.
So, right? So I had to make do with my workstation, my keyboard at home, and yeah. I just put all the tracks into a program called Logic Pro X for all of my musician friends out there who know what that is. And then sent that along for all of our performers to use tonight.
In perfect tempos. I mean, like, you just, an example was like, you got like show tempo for Robin Herder with like dance break and everything.
Oh, well, that took a lot of time and a lot of effort and a lot of help from a very special person of mine.
Who helped you achieve this wonderful goal?
So I have been quarantined and isolated and distanced with my wonderful sister, Rebecca Kaplan, who acted as my page turner throughout this entire experience, since I do not have my music stand or keyboard stand with me. So I need someone.
You cannot do it alone.
And press the thing.
I love it. I love it so much. Now, last question before I let you go, with extraordinary gratitude and just awe to you. We also heard your voice say, once upon a time.
I was that voice. I was the narrator. I was Tom
Aldridge. You were the narrator. You were Tom Aldridge. May he rest. We love him so.
Indeed.
Do you have any I wish roles that you long to play in the future or are behind you? Do you have any I wishes?
I have so many I wishes.
Top three.
Okay. I wish to be a human that can go to a restaurant in public with a mask on. I wish to be a person who can like hug my friends and wonderful family.
We love hugs.
I wish to be able to go on vacation one day, hopefully a cruise ship. I love cruise ships. They are my favorite.
But haven't like buffets and close-knit contact been canceled?
For now, unfortunately.
But you wish to be on one. It's so interesting. One day when our parents are together, you and me, we're hanging out with our moms, right?
Dad is watching right now.
Hi, Dad. Hi, Mr. Pell. My mom is watching in Detroit. One day I'll let her explain to you how much she doesn't like a cruise ship experience, and you can compare and contrast and convince each other that you're both right. My mom dislikes cruise ships so much that if there's ever an emergency, like she's been kidnapped and they put her on the phone, she's like, "Al, we're going on a cruise." That's like our red hot phrase, because she would never, ever choose to be on a cruise. So
we're going to have to agree to disagree.
That's okay. There's more cruise ship space for you then.
Yes. Yes, it is.
I love it. Well, Ben, thank you so much for everything you've done for us tonight and for our wishes of the past and the I wishes of the future, because you are an absolute rock star and I love you.
I love you more.
See you soon and it's see rough. You soon.
Yes, indeed.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, Ben Kaplan, thank you so much. Okay, our next guest, speaking of all these Broadway debutantes, is an absolute unbelievable talent, a New York City native. You most recently probably saw her in The Prom on Broadway, but also on in Aladdin on tour. And she was very, very recently in San Diego in the Peter Pan-inspired musical Fly at the Old Globe. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Isabel McCalla. Yay! So beautiful, but what is new?
You are so beautiful. Just to clarify, it was the La Jolla Playhouse that Fly was at.
I'm so sorry, the La Jolla Playhouse.
No, fine.
Regardless, paradise.
Paradise, I'm still here.
You're still sheltering in place.
That's a final little thing. Oh my God. Damn it. Well,
can you even?
Can you even? I'm still here.
I love it. But, and you got to actually fly. Like, you literally got to fly in Fly.
I literally did. I was on a line and I had a harness and everything. And I never touched, my feet touched the ground. I think a total of like 45 seconds the entire show.
Oh my goodness. Did you have to wear the like Kathy Rigby little like giant metal panties thing?
They weren't giant metal panties, but I did have this foam type thing called neoprene that I put inside my harness. So I had like a hip harness and I would shove the neoprene in so that the metal rings on the side where my line would get hooked into wouldn't chafe me too hard or cut into my skin. You know, you got used to it. It was a little numb at first, but you know, you just have to roll with the punches.
Because sometimes wishes to fly on a show do come true and you're like, be careful what you wish for.
Truly be careful. Although it was really fun because then I feel like I got to create my own brand of comedy, like flying comedy.
Which I love that so much, and I hope there's video that you'll share with the public.
There's definitely video of me struggling to figure it out at first, like me just falling. It's like, you know that Peter Pan when the wrong line gets pulled and he knocks the set down?
Absolutely.
Like, I didn't knock the set down, but I definitely couldn't get my leg over a door.
I love that. So in my head, right, you know that meme that's like, my plans 2020?
Yes.
I feel like it's like Izzy flying through the sky beautifully, like giving full Mary Martin, and then like 2020 is you with like your leg over the thing. Is that accurate?
Yeah, that is completely accurate. 100%. Track it down and make that.
I love it. Izzy, what is your I wish song tonight? What are you giving us?
Okay, so I am going to be singing Breathe from In the Heights. And I sent in a tape for the film years ago, and they made the right choice by not going with me. But it's what I would love to do, and I love the song, and I love the role, and so I felt like I might just sing it.
I love it.
And also, I live in Washington Heights in New York City, and I miss it so much. Perfect. And I miss it, so like kind of tying back into the Manhattan theme.
I love that so much. So your wish is coming true in the role, and you're just going to declare your wish to your love letter to Washington Heights. I love it. I love it. I love it. Ladies and gentlemen, to sing one of her wishes, Breathe, Isabel McCalla.
Okay. Hopefully this all works. This is my street. I smile at the faces I've known all my life. They regard me with pride. And everyone's sweet, they say, you're going places. So how can I say that while I was away, I had so much to hide. Hey guys, it's me. The biggest disappointment, you know. The kid couldn't hack it. She's back, she's walking real slow. Welcome home, just breathe. Just breathe. As the radio plays old forgotten boleros, I think of the days when this city was mine. I remember the praise, ay te adoro, te quiero. The neighborhood waved and said, Nina, be brave and you're gonna be fine. And maybe it's me, but it all seems like lifetimes ago. So what do I say to these faces that I used to know? Hey, I'm home. Hey, they're not worried about me. They're all counting on me to succeed. I am the one who made it out, the one who always made the grade. But maybe I should have just stayed home. When I was a child, I stayed wide awake, climbed to the highest place on every fire escape, restless to climb. I got every scholarship, saved every dollar, the first to go to college. How do I tell them why I'm coming back home? With my eyes on the horizon, just me and the GWB, asking G, Nina, what'll you be? Straighten the spine, smile for the neighbors. Everything's fine, everything's cool. The standard reply, lots of tests, lots of papers. Smile, wave goodbye, and pray to the sky. Oh God, and what'll my parents say? Can I go in there and say, I know that I'm letting you down? Just breathe.
Ladies and gentlemen. You're like, breathe. You are amazing. You are amazing.
Thank you.
Can't wait to get a drink in New York.
Yes.
Bye, honey.
Ladies
and gentlemen, can you believe this talent that's joining us from the safety of their homes tonight? It's absolutely unbelievable. And now I am so excited to welcome one of my absolute best friends in the world. You may know her from so many shows. It's absolutely ridiculous. The last revival of Company, Crybaby, On the Town, and of course, most recently, as her multiple award-winning leading role in Jagged Little Pill, my emergency contact, the L stands to my L selves, the great Elizabeth Stanley. Hi, El Stans.
Hello.
So beautiful. I'm so happy to see your face. I miss you.
Likewise.
Oh, I wanted to show you too. I'm in my bedroom right now, and I don't think I've ever shown you that your artwork. This is El Stans's artwork, is right by my bed and this little plant.
Look at that golden frame too.
I know. She got a little fancy frame because you're the real deal. El Stans is crafty, for those of you who don't know.
I do my best.
Where are you sheltering in place, my darling?
I am in Maryland. My fiance's family has a house here, so
wonderful.
I don't know how far I am from Ben. We might be close together, and I don't know.
You can maybe stand across the streets and like wave or something. Or he can set up his piano and you can sing across the street.
And I can practice projecting.
Exactly. And thrill the local people.
Thrill.
I love it. Oh, El Stans, what is your I Wish song that you're offering us tonight?
Oh, my I Wish is What Baking Can Do. Oh, I'm Rick. Oh my God, so many fun people saying hello.
Hello.
Yeah, I love baking. And
I know this. I have partaken of your delicious.
Yeah, so the role of Jenna is one that I always was like, oh, that would be so fun. But
so wonderful.
The show closed and I didn't go into it. And so I'm like, let's sing it here.
I love it. And that's exactly, like, this is exactly the platform for that, to make some wishes come true. And I think we all wish to hear you and your glorious instrument, which is not just, if I may say so, not your vocal cords, but also your spirit. You're like absolutely effortless melding of singing actor. I think you're peerless.
Pressure, Al.
No, I just, you're my hero and one of my very first friends in New York City. So without further ado, I miss you all, Stan. But without further ado, I'm going to offer the great wider interwebs, the great Elizabeth Stanley singing What Baking Can Do from Waitress.
Okay. Nope. Make it work. Make it easy. Make it clever. Craft it into pieces. Make it sweet. Crimp the edges. Or make it sour and serve with lemon wedges. Even doubt can be delicious. And it washes off of all the dirty dishes. When it's done, I can smile. It's on someone else's plate for a while. I'll place it on display. And then I'll slice and serve my worries away. Sugar, butter covered pieces. Never mind what's underneath it all. I have done this before. I'll beg me door to help me get through. I learned that from you, Mama. It's amazing what baking can do. Surprise them, tell them all my secrets, but disguise them so they dance on the tongues of the very people that they're secret from. Make it soon, make it better, though better never lasts forever. I'll make it small so it fits. Even this. Even now, even as the walls come tumbling down, even as I can't stop remembering how every door we ever made, we never once walked out. Something chance to ask her about. So with flour on my hands, I'll show them all how goddamn happy I am. Sugar, butter, flour, don't let me down. Let's see the next amazing thing baking does now.
Oh my God. Ladies and gentlemen of the world, Elizabeth Stanley. Oh, Elizabeth. I'm so happy you joined us from Maryland tonight. And thanks for being my friend. And thank you for gracing me. beautiful talent.
Thanks for putting this together. It's so fun to see so many people.
It's so much fun, and it's just a nice way to spread some joy. I'm sending you and Charlie and Maryland, the state, all my love and health and safety, and I'm just so happy to see you. And I'll see you soon in our private lives.
Yes.
Bye.
Good night, everyone.
Good night. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, the incomparable Elizabeth Stanley. And now, for something completely different, we're going to bring one of my absolute favorites to the show. An alum of I Wish, and you may know him as from the last revival of West Side Story, and as the perfect R-Pod from the most recent revival of She Loves Me. Ladies and gentlemen, Nicholas Barasch. I just love this man and his beautiful red hair.
Oh,
my sweetheart. Look at that. Look at that head of hair you're getting.
You know, it grows fast and thick, folks. My mom's giving me two haircuts in quarantine. Which have been successful because we have FaceTimed my barber. Her barber.
No way.
Yep. And he has gone through the motions with my
mom.
Got
the motions, maybe offered some moral support.
Yes, all of the above.
I love this so much. So where are you sheltering in place, my dearest?
I am in South Salem, New York, which is in Westchester.
Gorgeous.
I'm with my family, which has been great.
So wonderful. So wonderful. You are just, I just feel like you are one of the most incredible performers, especially having, you entered the business as a kid too. And to sort of see you, you know, really, you've kind of grown up in front of Broadway's eyes. So it's been an incredible transition, and lucky us to get to see that from you. So what is the wish that you are bestowing upon us today?
So the wish is a little known show called Fun Home.
I've heard of it.
I'm going to be singing Changing My Major. Honestly, any of the roles in the show and any of the songs, but this one, I feel like I'm the right age. Who knows if there will be a gender bent production at some point, but
can I posit my own I wish in this moment, since you're bringing it up? I just want to quickly say, what about
we're sisters. No, not sisters, the same.
We're each other. I'm ready. No. We're ready to go, world. So perfect. You're going to be giving us a little bit of Changing My Major.
I am.
I love it. Let's change that major. Ladies and gentlemen, the great Nicholas Barasch.
Okay, turn off the thingy, my bobber. What happened last night? Are you really here? Joan, 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 Joan. Hi, Joan. Wake up, Joan. Oh my God, last night. Oh my God, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God, last night. I got so excited. I was too enthusiastic. Thank you for not laughing, though you laughed a little bit. At one point when I was touching you and said I might lose consciousness, which you said was adorable, and I just have to trust that you don't think I'm an idiot or some kind of an animal. I've never lost control due to overwhelming lust, but I must say that I'm changing my major to Joan. I'm changing my major to sex with Joan. I'm changing my major to sex with Joan, with a minor in kissing Joan. Foreign study to Joan's inner thighs. A seminar on Joan's ass in her Levi's. And Joan's crazy brown eyes. Joan, I feel like Hercules. Oh God, that sounds ridiculous. Just keep on sleeping through this and I'll work on calming down. So by the time you've woken up,
I'll be cool, I'll be collected, and I'll have found some dignity. But who needs dignity? Cause this is so much better. I'm radiating happiness. Will you stay here with me through the rest of the semester? We won't need any food. We'll live on sex alone. Sex with John. Writing a thesis on Joan. It's a cutting edge field and my mind is blown. I would gladly stay up every night to hone my compulsory skills with Joan. I will study my way down her spine, familiarize myself with her well-made outline, while she researches mine. I don't know who I am. I've become someone new. Nothing I just did is anything I would do. Overnight, everything's changed. I am not prepared. I'm dizzy, I'm nauseous, shaky. I'm scared. Am I falling into nothingness? Or flying into something so sublime? I don't know, but I'm changing my major to Joan. I thought all my life I'd be all alone. But that was before I was lying prone in this dorm room bed with Joan. Look, she drooled on the pillow, so sweet, all sweaty and tangled up in my bedsheet. And my heart feels complete. Let's never leave this room. How about we stay here till finals? I'll go to school forever. I'll take out a dementedly huge high interest loan. Cause I'm changing my major to Joan.
Oh my goodness, and I'm sure the internet audience has joined me in being an absolute pedal on the floor. Nick, you are just an unbelievable vocalist and musical storyteller, and I'm just so honored that you've graced us not only with your presence once, but twice at I Wish.
Thank you so much, all, for creating this space. It's like my heart has been, what did I say in the song? Whatever, something about my heart. It's
cool. Oh my goodness. I joined the audience and Derek there, who said, we all wish we were Joan. And I wish you all the safety and all my love to Westchester to you.
Oh my gosh. Bye.
Bye, Nick. Oh, internet audience, we have a very, very special guest that I want to welcome you. She never makes public appearances. She is so famous and she is so in constant demand in the business and in the wider world. Ladies and gentlemen, the one, the only, my cat, Tatiana Angela Lansbury Romanov. Here she is, boys, here she is, world. Oh, Tati, thank you so much for coming to join us here at I Wish.
Hello, Human.
Hello, I feel so hashtag blessed that you are gracing us, the internet audience, with your presence when you have so many supermarkets to open and fans to greet and comments to respond to on social media.
You are welcome for this honor.
Tati, I can't help but notice that your voice is a little deeper than usual.
I have cold.
Are you sure it's just a cold?
It is cold.
Ah, well, I see. Anyway, as an internationally sought after performer with credits to your name, including Kitty Camsoil in the last production of Fiddler on the Roof on Broadway and across the globe in such roles as Kitty Capulet, Stupid Effing Cat, Cleocatra, and your celebrated multiple portrayal as Kitty Cost in Cabaret, I wanted to ask you about one of your greatest career agonies, the Cats movie.
Ah, Human, I cannot. It is too painful to discuss.
But please, Tati, the people want to learn from one of the greats of showbiz.
I did not even get appointment for the Cats movie. And all I can say is, look how that turned out for them.
Well, quite.
It is okay. We move on. We must be content with our potato ration. We must pick up the pieces of our broken fuzzy hearts and keep giving our gifts.
Oh, thank you so much, Your Majesty.
You are welcome, Homan. Homan, are you sick?
I
stay 6 feet away. Here is Kleenex.
Thank you, Tati.
Das vidanya, Homan.
Thank you so much, Tatiana Angela Lansbury Romanov. Oh, gosh, it's really, you know, this isn't what you think it is. I really do think that, that it's just psychosomatic, but I'm gonna do this anyway, you know, just to be sure, because you never know. But I should look up what's going on. It says here in this book, the average unmarried female, basically insecure, due to some long frustration, may react. With psychosomatic symptoms, difficult to endure, affecting the upper respiratory tract. In other words, just from waiting around for that plain little band of gold, a person can develop a cold. You can spray her wherever you figure the streptococci lurk. You can give her a shot for whatever she's got, but it just won't work. If she's tired of getting that fisheye from the hotel clerk, a person can develop a cold. Oh, where was I? Hold on. Here we go. Oh. The female remaining single. Just in the legal sense, shows a neurotic tendency, chronic organic syndromes, toxic or hypertense, involving the eye, the ear, the nose, and the throat. In other words, just from wondering whether the wedding is on or off, a person can develop a cough. You can feed her all day with a vitamin A and the bromophils, but the medicine never gets anywhere near where the trouble is. If she's getting a kind of a name for herself, and the name ain't his, a person can develop a cough. And furthermore, just from stalling the wedding trip, a person can develop blood grip. When they get on the train for Niagara, and she can hear church bells chime, the compartment is air-conditioned, and the mood's to blame. Then they get off at Saratoga for the 14th time. A person can develop la grip. La post nasal drip with the wheezes and the sneezes and a sinus that's really a pimp. From a lack of community property and a feeling she's getting too old, a person can develop a bad medical. Achoo! Thanks, guys. I really do think I'm gonna be okay. I think it's psychosomatic, really. Nothing to see here. No major health crisis on the horizon. But thank you for letting me work through my emotions. And yes, Paul, I'll pass the bromo fizz. Thank you all so much.
I wanted to say an excellent thank you to Mr. Ben Kaplan, who just knew exactly how to do my timings. I was just so thrilled about that. Now, you guys, if I just brought my cat onto the internet platform to talk with you and have my partner voice him in a horrible Russian accent, the only person that's probably closer to me in the world that has spent more time seeing me at highs and lows unclothed is my sister from another mister, one of the great, great, great singing vocalists of our time, one of the great singing actors of our time, my sister, Samantha Massell. Please welcome Samantha. Oh, stop it. Stop it. Be safe. Now, who is this? Tell the world who is this. This is my nephew. This is my niece.
She's been sleeping for the last 2 hours, and just as it was like almost my turn, she was like,
So do you think Bizet has any I Wish casting things that they would like to live out?
That's a great question.
Maybe some Sandy and Annie.
She's Australian Shepherd and Poodle, so like, I don't know, King Kong. That came from Australia, right? That was like
absolutely. Or maybe like the dog that accompanies the queens on Priscilla, the Queen of the Desert. Bus. Wonderful. For those of you who don't know the insanity that is the two of us, Samantha and I were Huddle and Seidel in the last Broadway revival of Fiddler on the Roof, and we shared a dressing room, shall I say infamously known as Dressing Room 51 at the Broadway Theater.
We were a little out of control.
We were a little out of control, and we started our own Instagram. Like, tell them why we started its own Instagram. It was because our friends were going to divorce us.
You know, when you meet someone who's your soulmate, and you spend 24 hours a day with them, you just like want to talk about them a lot and post about them a lot. And our friends were like, please stop.
You need to cool it.
Our own tiny corner of the internet just for us to celebrate our love. And you, and thus we did.
And thus we did. And one of the things I just want to remember that I don't think we've ever told the world is the very first day that we started Dressing Room 51, we would be in the show, right? And we'd be like, there are 18 people that are following.
Oh,
and
I remember that.
Like, you were like, 16 people. And you were like, 61 people. Like, it grew and grew and grew in number. And we just shared terrible advice and stupid things that we did by ourselves. But I do think it was like a platform for the joys of theater and the joys of why everybody falls in love with it in high school. Like, the fun of backstage and how pure.
I totally agree with that. And it was also just like fun to play around.
I know, to be sisters.
A serious show, we were like,
and neither of us have sisters, so it was our chance to like live that out.
Correct.
Sam, my doo-doo, which is what we call each other, internet, just you know, my doo-doo, what is your I Wish song that you're giving us tonight?
Okay, so it's a long walkabout.
I can't wait.
Walkabout, also awesome. Last time I asked me to do this, I had a really hard time figuring what to sing, and this time was no different. Anyway, so I'm from New York. I'm sheltering in place in New York. I put on clothes tonight.
Congratulations, you look beautiful.
My quarantine activity of choice, I have this dog obviously, is walking extraordinary lengths of the streets. Today, I haven't even gone out on my long walk yet and I've already done like almost 18,000 steps. I really lost my marbles.
Great.
I have a walking buddy, a few walking buddies, and when my walking buddies are not available, I keep catching myself, and I'm not making this up, singing to myself on the street. And
that tracks with the Samantha item.
Brian Stokes Mitchell has been singing from his fire escape, and I thought, you know what, I'm singing on the street, and there's this one song from the street that's really been in my head, and if I were going to do a fire escape show, you know, or window show, like the great Brian Stokes Mitchell, this is probably the song I'd sing. So this is, I guess, my I Wish I Was Brian Stokes Mitchell and had the ability to sing out my window on Broadway on the Upper West Side and have everyone pay attention. As opposed to me just walking with my mask going.
I love it. So you're dreaming the impossible dream, which is what Brian Stokes Mitchell is singing, basically. It's all coming full circle.
That's a great way to put it, in a much better way than I put it, I would say.
Every sister has her strength. I'm so happy to see you. I miss you. I love you. I'll talk to you in 5 minutes.
Okay.
And ladies and gentlemen, the world, the gift that is the instrument and the heart and soul of Samantha Massell. Love you, doo-doo.
I love you, doo-doo. Okay. There are some technical things that I'm supposed to do here. Let's apologies, everyone, in advance for this. Okay, I'm clicking the magic button. Okay, here we go. Come over here. You're not near enough. I see. I haven't made it clear enough. I couldn't be with anyone but you. With other men, I wasn't free. I don't know why. Oh, I was free enough to laugh, but not to cry. Well, I've laughed with you, and I've cried with you. And even on the days when I collide with you, you're the only one I want to be with. I couldn't be with anyone but you. Anyone else would find me boring, too quiet, too serious, too square. And who but you would tolerate my snoring? You even claim to like it. It tells you I'm still there. Your gallantry is just incredible. I know I disappoint you. You seldom let it show. I serve you steak that's practically inedible. How patiently you chew it. I don't know how you do it. For that alone, I'd never let you go. I have to be crazy to change the status quo. So come over here. Not near enough. I see. I haven't made it nearly clear enough. I feel safe with you and complete with you. I'm always finding money in the street with you. You're the only one I want to be with. The only one I can be me with. I know, 'cause I tried, and it's true. I couldn't be with anyone but you.
Is that something about me?
Yes.
I love you, Dudu. You are just, wait, what?
I want to say something really fast. The first thing is that my dog has been silent for 3 hours, and that entire time she brought me like no less than 6 toys. Here's my octopus. Here's my shark. Here's my ball. Here's my bone. I'm like, thank you so much. You
had is just pursuing her objectives.
Yes.
You know, it's just Stanislavski.
It's Stanislavski. I also just want to say, Al, I love you so much. Ben, Jen, all the rhymes here, what rhymes we have. I think all of us have been feeling so confused about what it means to be an artist. And my weird meaning of being an artist lately has been singing alone on West End Avenue through my mask. And this really, it's so beautiful and amazing to get to do this tonight. And okay, I'm done being a cheese ball, but I love you all. And
I love you, Samantha.
Later in the future.
You have such a gift, and thank you for sharing it with us. And I feel like I get all the secret, delicious extraness of you, and lucky, lucky me, and lucky world to be blessed by you. I love you. Stay safe, and I'll talk to you in 5 minutes. Bye. Oh my goodness. Can you believe that talent? Can you believe that I got to just listen to that girl warm up in her steamer every day? Now I want to welcome the producer and the manifester of this great, great idea, the answerer of my tweet, my partner in crime, the great producer that is Jen Sandler. I want to bring her on. Hi, Jen.
Hello.
You look absolutely gorgeous.
You look gorgeous.
Thank you. We're kind of giving our lace looks tonight, our lace looks.
Yeah, you know, when you're in quarantine, my rule is if ever I'm on camera, I have to look like I'm going out in public. So lace it is.
I totally love it. And I also love that you and I have both been talking recently as we've been planning this. Like, this is like the first time we both put on makeup in who knows how long.
Mm-hmm.
So you look gorgeous. Would you, I want to welcome you to talk a little bit about the mission of what's happening at 54 Below and everything. I want to like have you give you a space to discuss what's happening right now in our community.
Yeah, so I mean, 54 Below at Home has been happening since we started quarantining. So it's been probably almost 2 months now, which is kind of bonkers. And the amazing Nella Vera, who's our director of marketing, kind of started this, and it's kind of spearheaded to this amazing, amazing thing. And it's been a way to share joy with people, you know, with shows we've done in the past while we can't be in this club, in this living room getting, people keep saying, oh, I want to order my drink. And like, I'm like, you know, it sucks. Like I'm always, when I have my shows, like in the back by the bar with like my Pinot Grigio and like, I feel you, I want to drink my wine too. So, you know, this is a way for us all to be together while we can't be together.
Exactly. Exactly. And it's so amazing too, because 54 Below has in the years that it's been here, not only in this iconic spot that used to be Studio 54, it's really become like a legend of itself. I know, a legend of itself, providing like, it's basically Broadway Supper Club and
yeah,
the place where so many people get to share music outside the context of a Broadway show with the Broadway community and Broadway lovers.
Yeah, and I know we also have a fundraising campaign, I think, which was on the comments a little. You know, we are closed right now, so if you want to support our employees, there's a GoFundMe. I'll even ticker it for a sec. You have to GoFundMe, buy gift certificates. We will be back. And when we're back, we want to see people.
Absolutely. And like the fact that tonight is like such an amazing event that's free to watch. And, you know, some people can't make it to New York and some people can't afford the ticket price and the minimum of coming in to see a show live, but this is a way to keep events like this and all of the people that make 54 happen.
And there's so many people, like people don't realize there's an admin staff, there's tech, there's so many people that make
it. That's like the wait staff and the bars and the people that keep it clean and everybody that makes it what it is.
And there's people on here, I think I saw someone from like Australia, from like France, like absurd. Thank you for watching. I don't know what time it is for you.
Totally. Well, thank you. Thank you so much. And honestly, to you, Jen, just to echo what Samantha said, like, thank you so much for long ago being like, yes, let's do this. I feel like we've brought a lot of joy to a lot of people, and myself is included in that.
Ooh, can't wait to do it again in person.
Exactly. We can't wait to see you all in person at 54 Below live. But thank you so much, Jen. And please, if you can support the 54 Below staff and everybody that makes 54 Below happen at the link below. That is Thanks, Jen.
Love you.
Love you too. Okay, without further ado, I'm going to welcome one of the I Wish superstars. We were actually discussing how I Wish should definitely have like an all-stars show. And if that is true, we unanimously agreed that our next guest would be one of those all-stars, or like the first person out of our mouths. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm not going to hesitate. Please welcome Ain't Too Proud and a perpetual like genius star forever and ever and ever in every production ever in the history of the world, and my neighbor, Jelani Remy. Please welcome the genius that is Jelani.
I did.
I am dead for this.
Bored in the house, and I'm in the house bored, so I had to put up a background for you.
You had to put up. Are you in our hood right now?
I actually came home.
Yeah, good idea.
I decided to come home and be with family, and it's definitely like changed my spirit. But I miss you.
I miss you too. Jelani and I would like literally at least twice a week cross each other on the street and be like, hey.
Hey, girl. Yeah.
Oh, it is
supposed to be the next concert.
I know, exactly, because you are our star. Oh, let me be your star. But we've already let you be our star. I'm loving your background. I'm loving it so much.
This old thing.
How is your sheltering? How's your plague going?
My plague has been. It's had its peaks and valleys. If I'm being honest, you know.
Totally. Please be honest. This is really challenging.
Yeah. Like. It's been up and down, you know, because our best friend Broadway was sort of taken away.
Yeah.
For safety. And it's like, well,
for very good reasons, totally.
For very great reasons. But then for us artists, it became this weird sort of ebb and flow of, okay, purpose, value, exercise, artistic, laziness, whatever. And you had to figure out and navigate your way.
Right. Totally.
Which led me to my choices tonight.
You know? Please share with us your wish for this evening.
Okay. Well, I wish Disney knew how great they are. You know, because I've been watching the sing-alongs. I've watched them on GMA, and they've just, and obviously I grew up in the Disney family, for those of you who don't know.
Who doesn't know? You're on every bus in America.
Asian with the Lion King. So when I think about songs, Alec, I was like, you know, I was in Lion King, and I wish I got to sing one of the beautiful songs that Nala sang. Do you know which one I'm talking about?
I think I do.
But then I said, no, no, no. I came back home, think back, when I fell in love with my first Disney classic, and I'm home with my Caribbean parents, and it's like, Jelani, you want some breakfast? Which reminds me of Sebastian. Ariel, you must listen to your father. The seaweed is always greener in somebody else's lake. You dream about going up there, but that is a big mistake. Just look at the world around you, right here on the ocean floor. Such wonderful things around you. What more is you looking for? Then I thought, no. Disney has a wonderful way of inspiring us and motivating us and making us feel happy. Think about the future. Think about the heart. Go to the heart, which led me to Go the Distance. I have often dreamed of a far-off place where a great warm welcome will be waiting for me, where the crowds will cheer when they see my face. And her voice keeps saying, this isn't where I'm meant to be. I will find my way. I can go the distance. I'll be there someday. If I can be strong, I know every mile will be worth my while. I will go almost anywhere to feel like I belong. After all the years of heartache and despair I've known, I will finally find the answers on my own. I am on my way. I can go the distance. I don't care how far. Somehow I'll be strong. I know every mile will be worth my while. I will go most anywhere to find where I belong.
Oh my gosh, Jelani, you are an absolute genius. Absolute. You should see all these comments and everybody just losing their absolute mind.
Well, thank you. And thank you for this. Like, this is the platform we get to express. And I really value friends like you and everyone in the Broadway community that has reached out, and people that in my life and shows that have reached out and just said hello or sent care packages or made a funny meme. Like,
totally.
We are all in this together and we will get through it. And the artists need to suit up because we are the ambassadors of hope.
I couldn't agree more. And just as the lyrics of your beautiful song say, like, we can go the distance. We can do it. Oh, sweetheart, I'm sending you so, so, so much love to you and your beautiful background. And let's get a drink when you're back in the neighborhood.
Absolutely. Good night, okay. Everybody.
Good night, honey. Oh, just absolutely unbelievable, unbelievable talent. Okay, now, you guys, so exciting. We're welcoming one of my favorite, not only one of my favorite talents, but like one of my favorite human beings in the world. Incredible talent, humor, just a complete genius. You may remember him as one of Broadway's Jersey Boys and from the original cast of Waitress. And not only that, my favorite left-handed person, ladies and gentlemen, Drew Gehling. Look at that face.
Hey! You were all lace, and it started, and I was like, you know what?
Did you just, like, run to your closet?
Yeah, I'm clearly in my apartment, so wardrobe changes are an option.
Exactly. I did think, should I change my clothes? I don't know.
No, totally. And, like, our dinner just got here because I feel like it's not a 54 Below show unless I'm, like, sneaking through backstage.
A signature cocktail and a little bit of sneaking, particularly those plantain chips. Oh, my God, those are good.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah.
You look fabulous.
Thank you.
How's my favorite left-handed person doing?
So good, so good. I was just remembering back to our time in D.C. when I came and saw you in Camelot, and we like had our D.C. moment in our nation's capital.
Our Camelot cast did that like music and food night. You came and you hung out. We got drinks. We did deep talks.
I loved it.
You're a solid hang.
You know, I try.
You're the real deal. You're just the realest of deals. And
speaking of solid hang, the list of people that you have had tonight has just warmed my heart and through.
Well, you included, Drew. Like I just feel like, you know, it's this feels like such a platform for us to not only do the things that we'd never get to do, but right now it feels like just performing in general is the wish that of the thing that we wish we could do. And I wanted to welcome you to the series for so long. And you're just you're my brother. We've discussed this. We're like the
sip. Obviously.
What are your wishes that you're going to manifest tonight for us?
Okay. So, Samantha has West End Avenue, which ironically, so do I, but,
amazing.
And Stokes has his like concerts from his window.
Sure.
But I don't have those things. So, I have a 6-year-old daughter that I force to listen to all the things that I really would love to sing.
I really don't know what you're talking about. Did you not see the sketch with my cat?
Oh, yeah. Oh, kill it. You killed.
It's all talking. But I understand.
Oh, lovely.
Using props.
Yeah, so she is my prop. And so the slew of lullabies we do at night correspond with the kind of songs that I love to sing. And recently I've like gotten stuck on this one song from Peter Pan and it was like, I could never sing this song from Peter Pan because I'm a man. So, I decided that I was going to like, give this one a go, but I was going to give you Mr. Darling vibes to kind of bridge the gap.
And not only Mr. Darling vibes, but Mr. Darling vibes ready to go out with Mrs. Darling on a night in London.
Right. Yeah, so the kids are asleep. Nana's like put him to bed.
Totally.
And now we're gonna do a little number.
I cannot wait, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Trigan.
Nice. Now that you're off, now that I brought you all here for a very I'm just kidding. It's stupid. All right. Once upon a time, and long ago, I heard someone singing soft and low. Now when day is done, and night is near, I recall the song I used to hear. My child, my very own, don't be afraid, you're not alone. Sleep until the dawn, for all is well. Long ago this song was sung to me. Now it's just a distant melody. Somewhere in the past I used to know. Once upon a time, and long ago. The plan was to have my daughter come on, but she refused. So I'm going to show her artwork that we've created over the past couple of weeks. This is a mouse eating cheese. This is an owl. This is a rainbow unicorn. And this was a mess in the kitchen, but a good one. My child, my very own, don't be afraid, you're not alone. Sleep until the dawn, for all is well. Long ago this song was sung to me. Now it's just a distant melody. Somewhere from the past I used to know. Once upon a time and long ago.
Oh, that was absolutely unbelievable. I'm so glad you didn't go away.
Oh, yeah. I'm trying to.
There we go. Absolutely gorgeous. I should. That was just a blessing. I was just absolutely ravishing.
Oh, I love it. And honestly, now I have just enough time to put my mask on and run down the street and see if I can hear Julia Murney sing, because she lives right around the corner from me.
I think that's a great idea. And I think
I'm
you should
cheer on from the street.
I love it. Oh, Drew, it's so good to see your face. I miss you so much.
My love, Drew. All my love.
And I'll see you on the other side.
Bye, dear.
Bye, honey. Oh, Drew Gehling, ladies and gentlemen, just the absolute actual best. We are starting to come to the end of our evening, ladies and gentlemen. I want to welcome such an unbelievable talent. You may know him from Hamilton, and you may know him from Ain't Too Proud on Broadway. He actually made his debut, I believe, a week before the shutdown. And by the way, my new internet best friend, the great Nick Walker. Nick, please join us. Oh my gosh, babe, hi!
Hello.
It is so good to meet you.
I know, it's so good to finally meet you as well. Like, seriously, because
we feel like we have 100 mutual friends, and it's just the best. I'm so glad that you're here. Where are you sheltering in place?
So you are neighbors with Jelani, correct?
Yes.
So that means Ditmars is area?
Closer to Broadway.
So I'm Ditmars.
Amazing.
That's where I am. So I'm in the Queens. I love the Queens.
Maybe one day, very soon, in Astoria Park, we can sit 6 feet apart and enjoy an adult beverage and a Frisbee.
I cannot wait for that day. It's going to be great.
I look forward to that day. I'm just so honored to be your internet friend and now your face-to-face friend. Thank you for joining. I wish.
Oh, thank you for having me, man.
I have a sensation that your I wish offering has a story, and I would love to know a little bit about.
Yeah, man.
Your offering and why.
For those of you who know me, I always keep it 100%, and this is definitely a 100% story.
You do not bring it in at 80.
I do not bring it at 80. We're going to keep it 100 tonight. And no, so when I was a young lad, I got into storytelling really early in my life. And there was a lot of stories that really, really meant a lot to me, and a lot of plays that really meant a lot to me. And, you know, I wasn't into musicals quite yet, but the one musical that like was circling around when I was a kid was Rent. And what I loved about Rent was that, you know, even as a kid, I was such a pretentious asshole. So I was like going through, like, I have my dog-eared Glenn Ross script. And I was like, even as a kid, going through and be like, all right, like marking up the script and doing stupid, none of this made sense. But what I loved about Rent was that for the first time I heard a musical where the lyrics were dialogue. and where you as an actor could give it the subtlety and the nuance that you could give to a film or a mammoth script. I mean, it literally, if you read through that man's words, it's just so just specific and devil's in the details. So I was obsessed, and I was obsessed because I was like this young angsty teen. I was like, you have to understand, I was like plaid pants and like freaking paper clips through my hands and like duct tape wallet. So I was obsessed with Roger. I was like, this cat is the everything. And I was at camp, and I was about to do a talent. There was a talent show happening, and I was about to go up and sign up to sing the song I'm singing tonight, One Song Glory. And a camp counselor saw me signing up, and she pulled me aside, and she was like, hey, I saw you're about to sing One Song Glory. And I was like, yes. And she was like, you sure you want to sing that? And I was like, I mean, yeah, I love that song. Like, also, nice. I love, and like, I grew up listening to like the Rolling Stones, like Blink-182. So like, this was like right in my, you tell me this is a rock guy, like this is right in my wheelhouse, what I do. And she's like, are you sure you don't want to sing like I'll Cover You or like something like that? And I was like, I had listened to the album. I all respect to Jesse L. Martin. He's an incredible artist, and I love his work. But I was like, no, this is a song that I really love, and I want to sing. And she's like, it's just not, I forget her exact wording, but I'm gonna try to paraphrase. She's like, it's just not a song that they would let you, like. And she just, and it just trailed off. And keep in mind, like, I'm 12 years old, bro. I'm 12 years old. So this was the first in a long series of, you know, things that like kind of rude awakenings about myself, quite being blunt as a person of color,
right.
And the things that I wanted to do versus the things that I would be allowed to do. So this was a time that was very integral to me being like, yo, this is when I started writing my own work. This was because it was just like, I don't want to have to wait for someone to tell me that I can do this. I want to be telling my own stories, because they're going to try to put me in a box.
I love this. And I have to say, like, it's one of the exact reasons this series was created, why I wanted the series to exist, was because tonight your specific One Song Glory is not only allowed, is not only tolerated, because everyone knows there's nothing better in the world than being tolerated.
Yeah.
Please. It's not only allowed, it is welcome and celebrated, and as it absolutely should be on stages everywhere. And I'm just so excited to hear your One Song Glory tonight and make this wish come true for you.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
I'll see you soon in the neighborhood.
Yeah, so, see you in the neighborhood, my friend.
Exactly. Without further ado.
Thank you. And thank you guys for listening. And this is actually, this song means a lot to me. So I'm excited to give it a spin. We'll see what happens. One song before I go, glory, one song to leave behind. Find one song, one last refrain, glory, from the pretty boy front man who wasted opportunity. One song, he had the world at his feet. Glory in the eyes of a young girl. A young girl. Find glory beyond the cheap colored lights. One song before the sun sets. Glory on another empty life. Time flies. Time dies. Glory. One blaze of glory. One blaze of glory. Glory. Find glory in a song that brings truth like a blazing fire. an eternal flame. Find one song, a song about love, glory from the soul of a young man, a young man. Find the one song before the virus takes hold, glory like a sunset. One song to redeem this empty life. Time flies, and then no need to endure anymore. Time dies.
Oh, absolutely unbelievable, Nick. Thank you so, so much for joining us. And the gift was ours to bear witness
to
your one song glory. Right. I'm so, so, so happy that you've joined us. And I can't wait to hang out in the neighborhood.
Oh, seriously. Let's do it. Masks on, everything to do.
Can't wait. I'm feeling some like Astoria Park Frisbee. Let's do it.
Yes.
Thank you. Stay safe until then. Ladies and gentlemen, Nick Walker. Unbelievable. Such an amazing story. And I just, you know, I want to say so many people in this world are sent those negative messages and don't overcome that negativity. And what a moment of triumph. It's exactly what I wish is about. So I'm really, really thrilled that Nick joined us tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, we have come to the very end of our show, and it would not be I Wish without the people that I have to thank for making this happen. Before we leave tonight, I must thank KJ Hardy for our amazing, authentic 54 booth announcement. You probably didn't recognize his face, but you recognized his voice. Nella Vera, the 54 Below Director of Marketing. She has made 54 Below at Home happen. We wouldn't be doing this without you. Thank you so much. Dylan McDowell, Adrian Carnani, Grace Benigni, all marketing associates. Brian Nash for the I Wish Mega Medley. We collaborated on those great lyrics. Charlie Sermayan made the I Wish graphic for this edition of I Wish. Tatiana Angela Lansbury Romanov for her royal appearance. You can follow her online at I Feel Kitty. All of our performers tonight, your incredible talent and your spirit and your friendship has meant so much to me, and I know it's meant so much to the wider internet world tonight. Ben Kaplan, who, as you heard, recorded every single one of the tracks you heard tonight from his shelter in Maryland, and of course, additional thanks to his sister Rebecca for turning his pages. Jen Sandler, our truly incredible visionary producer. And I am Alexandra Silber. You can follow along at Al Silbs, incidentally a nickname and a tag that was given to me by Elizabeth Stanley L. Stams. And before we leave, I wanted to say some final things. So some are about the I Wish concept in general, and some are about the moment we're living in right now. Dearest, dearest viewers, I want you to think about a couple of things. Octavia Spencer was told that she was weird looking and not for Hollywood. Suck it, haters. She has an Oscar now and a series and a bunch of other wonderful things that are the trophies of success. Samuel L. Jackson recovered from a crippling addiction to cocaine and heroin before landing Pulp Fiction at 46. And even though Angela Lansbury, my idol, was nominated for an Oscar at 18, a Golden Girl, a movie, and gigantic Broadway star, she wasn't a household name until she starred on Murder, She Wrote, which she began filming at the age of 60. Not to mention Arianna Huffington, starting the Huffington Post at age 54, or Charles Darwin, who was 50 years old before he published On the Origin of the Species, at 51. Or Julia Child, who published her first cookbook at 39 and made her first television debut at 51. All of these people are proof that dreams and wishes do happen, and that most importantly, it is never too late for anything. I Wish has always been a really special evening, every time we've ever come together. But tonight's has been extra special. Why? Because tonight you have watched people live their dreams. And not only that, you have witnessed our guests live out those dreams under unimaginable circumstances, against all odds. It shows us that a way is always there with the help of improvisation, a willingness to pivot by making amendments to the original plans, and above all, by embracing what is rather than being stuck in what is not. I hope these generous, gifted people have buoyed and uplifted you tonight. I hope that by seeing them live out their wishes, they've reminded you why you're still pursuing yours. It is my greatest wish, more than anything, more than life, more than the moon, that we'll all be together again, as soon as it's safe. We will assemble in person again. We will feel the magic of performer and audience engaging in the singular, circular exchange of energy between performer and audience. We will tell and bear witness to the universal stories that can only be told live in a theater. And it is my great belief that artists will be the essential workers of tomorrow. Artists, and that includes those that love the arts, will be there for society to make meaning of all of this. And I know we will. And that is knowledge. That is no wish. And so, until that sacred day, I wish you all a safe, healthy, expansive summer. And now, to close out our evening with an anthemic song traditionally sung by a little girl with hopes for a brighter future in a broken world. The genius singing actor extraordinaire that you know from Andrew Lippa's Wild Party and is one of the most iconic Elphabas in Broadway's Wicked, not to mention much, much more, my friend and one of my inspirations, Broadway's Julia Murney.
The sun will come out tomorrow. Bet your bottom dollar that tomorrow there'll be sun. Just thinking about tomorrow clears away the cobwebs and the sorrow till there's none. When I'm stuck with a day that's gray and lonely, I just stick out my chin and grin and say, the sun will come out tomorrow, so you gotta hang on till tomorrow. Come what may, tomorrow, I love you. Tomorrow, you're always a day away.
If we were all at 54 Below right now, this would be the time when I would implore you to sing the end with me. And then when I heard you all go, I'm scared, I don't want to, I would shame you. But I can't shame you here. So I thought, what can I give them? A key change. What more could you possibly want? Sing these lyrics if you need to hear them. And if you don't need to hear them, somebody else does. When I'm stuck with a day that's gray and lonely, I just stick out my chin and grin and say, oh, the sun will come out tomorrow, so you gotta hang on till tomorrow. Come what may, tomorrow,
today away. Tomorrow, tomorrow, I love you tomorrow. You're always a day.
Ladies and gentlemen, Julia Murray, thank you so much for finishing our show with such class and grace and the message we all need with such peace.
For all of you, anything. The three of you.
Love you,
Jill. You did a beautiful thing tonight. Thank you.
Thank you, Julia. Are we still live?
You're still live, yeah.
You guys, I just want to say to everybody watching, on behalf of myself, Ben Kaplan, Jen Sandler, from 54 Below at Home, to all of you out there everywhere, we just got to hang on till tomorrow, and we'll see you all at 54 Below live very, very soon. Good night, everybody.